Good morning, students. Today we will discuss the question answer of the lesson The Third Level written by Jack Finney. Now, first of all, let us discuss what does the third level refer to. The third level refers to the Grand Central Subway, which will carry passengers to Galesburg, Illinois. The station's third stage was a means of relief from the harsh realities of everyday life for Charlie, the narrator of the story. It provides him with a foundation where fantasy and reality could be interwoven. Now, next question. What do you infer from Sam's letter to Charlie? Infer means interpret. Now, as you know that Sam, in the story, Sam has written a letter to Charlie from Galesburg in the year 1894. The letter was found in the first day covers of his grandfather. The letter was addressed to Charlie but mailed to his grandfather in Galesburg, Illinois. It was mailed in the year 1894 and now appears in his grandfather's collection. Now, the letter was suddenly found among the first day covers where it had never been seen earlier. Secondly, the contents of the letter are exactly what Charlie thought about Galesburg of 1890s. Sam's letter to Charlie is a mystery that blends together the world of reality and fantasy. Now, we can interpret this letter from two perspectives. At one level, we can say that Sam has reached Galesburg of 1894. However, if we look at the deeper level, we can interpret that letter is just another instance of Charlie's imagination or his dream of escapism. Charlie was looking at the old first cover letter. He was carried away to a different world where the letter was sent to Charlie by Sam. So this actually Charlie tries to give a proof of his imagination. It may be possible that the letter might have been written by Charlie himself. So it is just, we can say, Sam's letter is the imagination of Charlie. Next question. The modern world is full of insecurity, fear, war, worry and stress. What are the ways in which we attempt to overcome them? In the very first video, I told you that the people try to escape from the realities of life. So, what do? To get rid of this insecurity, fear, war and worry, the people indulge in various activities to get a temporary relief from that. So, now, through participating in some practical and helpful practices, we can conquer the anxieties and insecurities created through our unavoidable lifestyle. Cultivating interest, spending time with family and friends, going on excursions and vacations, doing meditation and exercise, all these help us lead a happy, safe life. Reading good books, And also by reading good books, we can get a vast store of wisdom. And because from in the books we learn from the experiences of others and remain rooted in those essential human qualities, joining sports, attending social activities, all and adopting various hobbies like listening to music, playing with pets, occasional dinner outside, watching movies, going to the places such as parks, temples, all these are a ways to get rid of the tension, boredom and anxiety. So these are the various ways to overcome the stress and tension. Do you see, now next question, do you see an intersection of time and space in the story? Intersection of time and space in the story. Now, you, as you know, that the, that Charlie was living in the 20th century, and when he goes to the third level, he reaches in the 19th century, that is 1894. Again, his friend Sam has written a letter to him in 19th century, and he receives that letter in the 20th century. So now there are certain instances in the story which show that intersection of time and space is there. You know, first two levels of Grand Central Station were located in the present time, while the third level existed in the 19th century. Charlie and his wife Louisa live in present time, yet he rushes to get old currency to buy two tickets to go to Gettysburg of 19th century. Again, the architecture or the platform at third level is different from the modern platform of the first two levels. So, and again, the world, the newspaper, the world, dated 11th June 1894, also overlaps with Charlie's real-time world and existence. And as I have already told you that Sam has sent a letter to Charlie's grandfather on 18th July 1894. Again, this highlights the intersection of time and space, as the sender, that is Charlie's friend Sam, and receiver, that is Charlie himself, belong to the present time. So in this way, there is an intersection of time and space in the story. Now next question. Apparent illogicality sometimes turns out to be a futuristic projection. Discuss. Yes, apparent illogicality sometimes turns out to be a futuristic projection, it's rightly said, because if we talk of the time when the Wright brothers invented the first aeroplane, then nobody could dare to believe that a man could fly. And again, you know, before Alexander Graham Bell invented the telephone, it would have been impossible to believe in long distant talks happening in the real time interface. And again, the people couldn't even think of that we are sitting in Panipat and talking with the people who are living in America, and we are also able to see their pics also, their video also, and that also without any wire, that is without any wire connection. So such things seem to be illogical at the time, in the before the invention of the telephone, but these things have brought a revolutionary change in the future of mankind. So it is sometimes the things may appear to be illogical, but later on these bring a great change in the future of mankind. This become the this becomes the basis for the future research. Now similarly, now here we in this chapter, if we talk about this chapter, here it seems to be far-fetched. It is very far-fetched to think of that a person is going to the 19th century and again coming back to the 20th century. It may be possible, it may be that some inventions may occur, may happen, and all these things, a time machine may be invented which could take the persons from one era to the other era, even though at this time it appears to be quite illogical, quite irrational. Now, next question. Philately helps keep the past alive. Discuss other ways in which this is done. What do you think of the human tendency to constantly move between the past, the present, and the future? Now, in philately, the people collect the stamps, coins, and this is a pastime, this is a hobby. And there are other hobbies also, there are other ways also by which we used to keep the past alive. For example, collecting historical artifacts, paintings, inscriptions in the museum, collecting and reading books, write autobiography, bio sketches, diary entries, and collecting and viewing documentaries and other videos, all are a few ways of revising history. Besides, we keep our culture and traditions alive when we follow the rituals in ceremonies. Again, we used to keep our videos, photographs, audio collection. All is what? That we all are trying to keep the past alive. Even in the marriage, why we take that photographs? Why we make the videos? That is to keep the past alive. So, there are various ways and to keep the past alive, and it is the human tendency to constantly move between the past, present, and the future. That is what we are doing at present. That is the result of the past. What is our present behavior? That is what we have learned from the past, and what we are doing in present, that is to make our future bright. So it is the human tendency to constantly move between the past, present, and future. So these are some of the questions based on this chapter. So you should write down all the answer to the questions in your notebook.